In this video, we're going to talk about adding the restaurant schema in a schema generator. And if you are a restaurant owner, that schema isn't meant for you. You should be looking at the local SEO module instead. You can find the tutorial right here. The link is in the description. This restaurant schema is meant for third-party restaurant reviewers, such as for sites like the Michelin Guide, where they put the tastiest restaurants on their list and apply the restaurant schema on each individual review page. If we copy the URL of this page, go to Google's Rich Results Testing 2 and test the page, and you will find these schema types. Under the organization schema, expand this, and you will see that the page has implemented the restaurant schema. So if you are or aspire to be a restaurant reviewer, let me show you how to add the schema to your site. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one SEO plugin that empowers millions of WordPress users, and this channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, subscribe. And without further ado, let's get into it. Before adding the restaurant schema, you need to make sure that the schema structured data module in the RankMath's dashboard is turned on. Thereafter, you can go to the page where you want to add the restaurant schema, click on the RankMath's tab, and select the schema tab. Then click on the schema generator, and from here, you will find the restaurant schema. Let's click to use it, and now we will talk about what to add to each of the schema fields. The information to add to the restaurant schema fields is rather straightforward if you are a restaurant reviewer. But before we talk about what to add to these fields, you've got to know that any fields marked with this red asterisk are considered mandatory fields, which means if nothing is added to the field, the schema will not work. And it happens that the headline field is the only mandatory field. And you don't have to worry if it is empty because of this SEO title variable here. This SEO title and description variables will take information from the SEO title and description fields in the edit snippet right here and here. This title variable will take information from your page title by default. So if you have a title and content on your page, you shouldn't worry about not having any information on these two fields. But anyway, the headline field is meant for you to add the name of the restaurant you're reviewing, or a descriptive title that prominently features the name. This helps search engines identify the business and may influence how it appears in the search results. For example, if the name of the restaurant is The Spice Garden, you could simply enter the name as is. However, you can also make it more engaging and SEO friendly, such as expanding it with relevant details like incredible Indian cuisine in downtown Chicago. This not only includes the restaurant name, it also highlights the cuisine type and location, which can improve visibility in local searches. So the best practice is you definitely need to have the restaurant name and keep the description clear and concise. Also, you should incorporate keywords strategically and possibly having a matching title between your page title and the schema headline. So if you have optimized your page title with the best practices and you have not made any changes to the SEO title, you do not need to add anything to this field because it eventually takes information from your page title. Next is the description field. You should write a compelling summary of the restaurant that helps both search engines and potential customers understand what makes the establishment unique. This description should be a concise yet informative overview of the restaurant's concept, cuisine, atmosphere, and key selling points. For example, something like this: The Spice Garden serves authentic Indian cuisine in Chicago's downtown, featuring tandoori specialties, vegan options, and craft cocktails. A vibrant atmosphere perfect for dates or group dining. There is no restriction to the length of your description, but try to be as concise as possible, possibly below 600 characters. Next, let's keep the short code towards the end to show you how all schema information will look on a page if you decide to display them. Let's move on to the phone number. This should be straightforward. Assuming the restaurant's phone number is this, where there is a country code and area code, you would add the phone number with no spaces or hyphens as best practice, so that users can easily dial the phone number directly through rich snippets or through voice search. Next is the price range field. Depending on the country where the restaurant is located, you would add your currency symbol to this field. For example, this restaurant is in the US, so it will be in dollar sign. If the restaurant is located in Britain, it will be in pounds. Anyway, $1 sign means the food is cheap. It is mainly for fast food, casual cafes, hawker food, food from the food court, etc. The food is not expensive. $2 sign means moderate pricing, such as $15 to $30 per entree. This will be those mid-range restaurants. $3 signs means expensive, for example, fine dining, tasting menus, etc. And finally, $4 signs means very high-end, which are meant for luxury establishments. So please only add currency symbols in this field. Next are the address fields. They should be straightforward and need no further explanation. So I will just add the address here. The only thing you need to take note of is that the accepted format for the country field is the two-letter ISO 3166 format, which you should already know, such as Canada is CA, Sweden is SE, India is IN, and the United States of America is US. So over at this field, I will add US. And then the geo-coordinates. You can easily find these information on Google Maps. For example, as we visit Google Maps, let's say that this Indian Garden restaurant is where the restaurant is located. All you need to do is to hover over it, right-click, and you will see the latitude and longitude coordinates. Let's click to copy, back to the fields, and paste it. The first coordinate is latitude, while the second coordinate is longitude. So we have to add them accordingly. Next is the opening hours. If you are a free RankMath user, you can only add one set of operating hours, which is fine if the restaurant has only one set of opening hours. For example, if the restaurant opens every day except Monday, you would check all the days except for Monday. And the opening time, let's say that it opens at 10 a.m. to 11 p.m. at night. The time is in a 24-hour format, so you have to select this accordingly. If one set of operating hours works, that's great, but if there are restaurants that have two or more sets of opening hours, for example, if it opens at 10 a.m. and closes at 2 p.m., and then it opens up again at 6 p.m. and closes up at 11 p.m., in that case, you would need RankMath Pro. So here's how it works. Earlier, we had the opening days as follows. We will keep it as it is. The first set of opening time will be 10 a.m. to 2 p.m., which is 1400 hours. And to add a second set of opening hours, we simply have to click on the Add Property group right beside the Opening Hours field, and a new set of opening hours will appear. We will select the same opening days, and the second set of opening hours will be 6 p.m. to 11 p.m. So this is how it works if a restaurant has two different opening hours. It will be best if you have the same information on the same page. I hope this is easy for you to understand. Next is the Serve Cuisine field, which is a critical component for telling search engines and potential diners exactly what type of food the restaurant specializes in. In our example, it will be Indian. So I will click Add Property and include Indian here. And if the restaurant serves fusion food, like Italian and Indian food, you can simply click Add Property again and include Italian. This is straightforward. Keep this below 5 cuisines. Now, the best practice for this field is to avoid unrecognized terms like Bangkok style. And instead, you should include recognized terms like Thai. But anyway, this should be straightforward. In our case, it would just be Indian. And finally, the menu URL. Let's say that this is the page of the restaurant that includes the menu. We can simply copy this link and paste it in this field. And once we are done with all these fields, let's click Save for this post and save the changes for this page. All right, we have all the information added, but you must be wondering, what about the review rating schema for the restaurant? Don't worry, we will talk about that in a while. For now, let me show you how to display those schema information on your page. That is if you want to. Remember earlier about this shortcode field? That's what you need to copy and paste to your page if you want to display all these information on your page. So let's copy it, go to the page, and let's paste it right at the bottom of the page so that we can easily identify the information. Let's save the page, visit it, scroll to the bottom, and here we go. These are all the information you have added to the schema fields. If you want to display this information on your page, that's how you would do it. However, if you do not wish to display the information, you can simply ignore the shortcode field and the schema will still work in the background. And now that we have all the information in place, we have got to know if the schema works. So let's test it. So on the page where we have added the schema, let's right click and view its page source. And then Ctrl or Command A to select everything, and Ctrl or Command C to copy the codes. And then visit Google's Rich Results Testing tool. This is the link to the tool. The same link is in the description. Let's select the code option and paste the copied codes here. And let's test it. Give it a while. And here we go. The restaurant schema is under the organization tab. And as we expand this, we can see that this is a restaurant schema. And these are all the schema information we have added. There is no error or warnings, which means everything is in place. So using RankMath to add schema information of a restaurant is straightforward. But the thing is that it is still missing the review rating schema. So let me show you how to do it. So to add the review rating schema to the existing restaurant schema will require us to customize the schema, and you would need RankMath Pro. Now note that we are adding the review rating schema that includes your personal opinion about a restaurant and not aggregating a group of ratings from your readers. If that is what you're looking for, then you can check out a plugin called WP Review by My Team Shop. Anyway, let's get into it. Now, I recommend that you add all the necessary information in this restaurant schema before customizing it, because it is much easier to do so. And since we have included all the information, we can hover over the Advanced Editor and click on it. And you will see a prompt like this saying that you can't revert back to the simple editor mode as you have been using. So just take note of that. Let's click OK. And this is how the advanced editor looks. Now don't worry if it looks confusing, just follow along. Let me brief you a little on properties and groups. As you can see, each view over here is a property and the address schema is a group. And within the group, there are properties. The same goes for the geo coordinates. For the opening hours, there is a larger group, and within it, there is a smaller group. And within a smaller group, there are properties. I hope you can grasp the hierarchy concept. Anyway, to add the review rating schema, you first need to add a group. So right at the top of the restaurant schema, you need to click on Add Property Group. And as you scroll to the bottom, you will see a new group added. The group name will be Review. Please have them in all small letter casing, because that's how search engines understand it. Following that, we need to define the group type. So we will click Add Property. And then on the first view, we will add type and define it as Review. Similarly, follow the letter casing. Thereafter, we need to add another property group within the review group so that we can include all the review rating information. So right beside the review group, we will click Add Property Group, and let's name this group as Review Rating. Please follow the letter casing exactly. And then within this review rating group, we need to add three properties. So we will click Add Property three times. In the first field, we will add type and define this group as rating. The next field will be rating value. And this is the rating you give to a restaurant. So let's say that you are satisfied with the restaurant's food and service, we can give it 4.8. And as for the next field, we need to let search engines know 4.8 out of what. So we will add best rating and it will be 4.8 out of 5. Now there is one more group we need to add within this review group, which is to let search engines know who has left this rating. So right beside the review group, we will add another property group and we will name the group as author. And similarly for every group, we need to define what it is. So we need to add a property, include add type, and define the group as person to say that it is the person who has added the review rating. And then let's add another property to let search engines know the name of the person reviewing the restaurant. Let's say that it is me, so I will add Jack Chow. And that's basically it. So we have a review group, we have defined the group as a review, and then within this review group, we have another group called review rating, where it contains all the rating information, and then we have another group to tell search engines who is the person or organization who have left this rating. So let's save for this post and save the page as well. And then let's test it. Let's view its page source, copy the codes, and let's test it on Google's rich results testing tool. Give it a while. And here we go. Now we see the review rating. And there is no error, which means everything is in order. So that's how you can add the review rating schema to the existing restaurant schema. Now, what I've shared is mainly for reviewing a single restaurant, but what if you are writing a list of top 5 Indian restaurants in Chicago? How would you add that schema? Let's talk about that. Assuming we are writing a piece of article about the top 5 Indian restaurants in Chicago, we can't simply add one restaurant schema. So if you have RankMath Pro installed, we can add 5 restaurant schema. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. and you will fill up all the information for each restaurant on the page. So we have added the information for the first restaurant. Now to the second restaurant, we'll add the headline, the description, and everything else for the restaurant. And then the third restaurant will correspond to the third restaurant schema, and so on. And to add the review rating for each restaurant, after you have completed all the information, simply go to the restaurant schema and switch it to the advanced mode to add the schema fields we have talked about earlier. So it is rather straightforward once you understand the basics. That's how you can add the restaurant schema to pages where you are reviewing restaurants. If you have any questions or suggestions, feel free to leave a comment down below and don't forget to smash that thumbs up. Our channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic, and if you haven't subscribed to us yet, consider doing so. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.